Hey, this is Job Stauffer from Telltale Games. We're here at the PlayStation Experience in Las Vegas, Nevada, here to talk about Telltale and everything we're doing.
So one of the big things you guys are doing is working with HBO and Game of Thrones. What has it been like to have that property as a video game?
It's an absolute incredible honor to be working with HBO. Everyone at HBO is just so fantastic to work with, and you know, they're the leaders in scripted storytelling and just absolutely phenomenal to work with. And it's been a long time coming for Telltale. It's been 10 years. This is actually Telltale's 10th year anniversary of really building on this dream of being able to work with Hollywood and work with television and really speak in the same language as TV producers and film producers, in that we're approaching our content with the mindset of story first and writing first and character first, and really taking stories and making them interactive, and really giving the story into the hands of the player to take it and make it their own.
What do you feel you learned from Walking Dead, another very popular show, that you've applied to Game of Thrones?
I think we've learned, and we learned this with every series that we're doing, so coming from Walking Dead through things like The Wolf Among Us and now also Tales from the Borderlands and Game of Thrones, we learn to listen to the audience as much as we can. And really the player becomes really the last part of the development process, and we say this a lot, but it's true. We just did a panel here at the PlayStation Experience talking to the fans about how when you play a Telltale game and you're making decisions and you're deciding, you know, what this character's going to do, if you're gonna let this character live, if you're gonna let this character die, or choose this person to help you or that person to help you, those choices and that story that you're creating, we're seeing all of that data and we're seeing the game that you're playing, and that's informing us in our writing and our game design decisions in every episode going forward. So we did a lot of that in The Walking Dead and everything we've done since then, and every component of being a part of that experience for the players is rolled into everything we're doing right now.
When it comes to Game of Thrones, can you talk a little about where this game fits into the universe?
It's actually, you know, it's set in the universe of the HBO show, their amazing Emmy Award-winning TV series. It starts right towards the end of their third season, and you're going to be playing as a family known as House Forrester. And the Forresters, they live at this place called Ironwrath. It's up in the Wolfswood in the north. And you're experiencing basically the events of the show from the perspectives of a family as they experience the fallout of everything that happens at the end of season 3 and onward.
What does that open up for you guys creatively, not following the exact storyline that people have read in the books or watched on a TV show?
I think it's the same reason why we chose to go with telling a story about Lee and Clementine in The Walking Dead as we'd apply it here to Game of Thrones. You know, with Walking Dead, everyone already knew Rick's story, and they already know what happens to Rick, and they're seeing what's happening to Rick in every issue of the comic. So with shows like, you know, Game of Thrones, to tell the same story that's being told on HBO doesn't necessarily make the same sense because the player already knows what's going to happen. And there's not a lot of play space there for design and for writing. So to be given the opportunity to work with, you know, tremendously talented partners like HBO and Robert Kirkman and Skybound and Gearbox and create original characters hand in hand with them, it's just fantastic just to keep adding to and expanding these universes and these stories that we love so much.
When it comes to the HBO show, can you talk about some of the actors you've worked with on this video game?
We have an incredible cast of original characters that you've never seen before in the show. There are a few characters that you will recognize from HBO's series. Lena Headey, Cersei, Peter Dinklage, Tyrion, Ewan Rand, Ramsay Snow, Natalie Dormer as well. If you've played through the first episode, you've seen a few teases. We will be seeing Kit Harington as Jon Snow in later episodes. We will be seeing Dany, Emilia Clarke in later episodes as well. Can't really discuss anything further about how they're going to fit into the story. We want to leave that as a surprise to the fans. But it's just been fantastic, and just being able to work with such amazing, incredible talent is just an honor for us. And we're looking forward to doing it for, you know, this is our biggest series ever. 6 episodes for Game of Thrones, and we're just getting started.
When it comes to beyond the actors, can you talk about how you've worked with HBO in a sense? Did you get access to sets or other elements that helped you create this version of the show?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the art and the set design, the costume design of Thrones is just so phenomenal. You know, they have a traveling Game of Thrones exhibit. If you ever get the chance to see that, it usually travels the country and the world. Head to it, wait in line as long as you have to. It's phenomenal. They have all of the set pieces, the throne, the costumes, everything you could ever possibly want to know about how they produce that show. You can see that at the Game of Thrones experience. I definitely recommend you check that out. But, you know, we're looking at stuff like that. We're looking at, you know, pictures from the set. We're looking at all the costumes and the finest detail and how to really, you know, represent that as best we can in the game and really recreate that in an interactive format. And that's just such an honor for us. We're such big fans.